Using the Porsche ad that we've been working on for a little bit, I'm going to show you how to make this ad clickable. So we've been working with this one, and I just made some changes a minute ago so that I can animate the mask. You see the mask where the car is revealing the Porsche logo behind it as it drives by. So depending on the order you're watching these in, you may or may have not seen that one yet. But I'm pretty happy with this one, and I want to actually make it clickable now so that once this is posted on someone's page, they can click on it. We'll take it off to view another website. Okay. So first, I want to make sure I'm working in scene one. So up here in the upper left-hand corner, make sure I'm not in any of my symbols. And I'm going to come down to my timeline panel down here. And I want to make a new layer, which I'm going to call button. And I'm going to put it directly below my actions layer. So I clicked on logo mark, I add a new one, and I'm going to name this button. Okay, so that gives me the place to put my action or my clickable button. So make sure your playhead is on frame one. Okay, so I'm right there on frame one now. And I want to go back and get my rectangle tool. Okay, move over here to my toolbar. And I want to check and see what color I have. So I have no stroke, that's great. My fill is kind of a bright green with 50% of the alpha, so that works well for me. So I am just going to stick with that. Oh, sorry, hit a key. Got a little preview going there. Okay, so I checked my color, I'm okay with that. Let's get myself back to frame one. Make sure I have my rectangle tool. I'm all set there. Checked my color on it, that is great. So now I want to draw a rectangle over the area that I want clickable. In this case, I want the whole thing clickable. So I'm going to the upper left-hand corner. I'm going to click and I'm going to drag down to the bottom right-hand corner. And you'll notice that actually that's what the guides are indicating. My guides are indicating where my stage is. So I really should go open this sky image and crop it and then replace it back in here. I have a lot of extra image I'm not using. But my guides do indicate my stage, so I've drawn it right at that area right now. I'm going to go back up and get the arrow or the selection tool up here. Come select my rectangle that I have, and now I want to convert this to a symbol. So that's found up in the Modify menu, or I can do a right click on it and go down and say Convert to Symbol. Okay. I need to name this something. I'm just going to name it Button. So I have a symbol named button, and I want to make sure that I make the type be button. So we've been using movie clip up till now. This one actually needs to operate as a button. So I'm going to go ahead and say OK. OK, now back over it again. I'm going to double click on it. That's how I go edit that symbol. You can see in the upper left-hand corner right here. See, I'm in button now. And you notice now that my timeline down here is different. So I need to pay attention to this. I have up, over, down, and hit. Hit is the click state on it. And so that's defining what is clickable by the user. So over here on up, you can see that I have my rectangle showing. So I'm going to click on this rectangle right here, the thing that's becoming my button. And I want to go up and cut it. I want to remove it because it doesn't need to show up there. And now I need to come over to my hit frame here. Select my hit frame. I'm going to right click and I want to put a blank keyframe there. Okay, so insert blank keyframe. And now I can go back up to my edit menu and I can say paste in place. Okay, so see here it is and it's on my hit. So if I go to up and over and down, it's not there. On hit, it is there, okay? So make sure I have that selected. Okay, so everything is in my hit frame, nothing on the other frame. So now I want to go back over to scene one, okay? Get out of there. Notice that it's still there. It's kind of displaying as a light blue now, so you can see it right here. So I'm going to click on that, make sure I have that selected. And I need to go back over here to my properties panel. So see my properties panel up here. And it needs an instance name. So just give it something simple. I'm going to call mine button underscore link. It's the button that causes me to go to a link somewhere. Okay, so give it some kind of name right there. Hit return, so it accepts that. And now I need to go to my actions panel. So remember, your actions panel is up here under window right there. I had actually put mine right over here, so but you might not have. And once I get there, I need to go to the code snippets. So open up code snippets. So I'm working in HTML5 canvas. Okay. And not the timeline navigation. This time I'm moving down to actions down here. And I need to find the click to go to web page, because that's what we're trying to do. So I'm going to double click on that. And you see it puts the code in place for me. So once again, there's some comments up at the top. You can read through those. The main thing I'm looking for here, drag it out just a little bit, is right down here. You see this is the website it's going to redirect it to. Okay, so you can leave the instructions or delete them, or the comments, I mean, either way. I'm going to come down here, and I think I will replace this. I really should do the Porsche site, but honestly, I don't know that URL off the top of my head, so since this is just a test, I'm going to send it to my business site. So I'm going to redirect them to michaelhayes.biz. Okay, so that's giving them their address. So now once I get that, I can close the actions panel. Okay, now the button is always on the stage. See, we are right here. We did it on the first frame, so it always shows up and it continues to monitor the whole time, watching for a click. So we can test this. I'm going to do a command return to go check. Okay, there is my animation. If I put my mouse up here, you see that it's clickable. Okay, let's refresh and put my mouse, and you see it's clickable this whole time. Okay, now back over here, if I wanted it to not work immediately, I could go here and I could move this point right here on frame one and drag it out to the point that I want the button to start to be clickable. In this case, because the whole thing's clickable, that might not make sense. But I could pick, you know, like out here at frame 50 or something, on another layer, a button then shows up, and then the clickable action starts working as well. Okay? So that is how this works and how we are able to make our ad clickable.